I made one of the dumbest and most regretful decisions I've ever made last year, and it was due to a stalker. I'm a male, and this happened many years ago when I was a senior in high school. The girl I had been dating at the time had secretly been seeing someone else, resulting us in obviously breaking up, and I wasn't doing well because of it. Being a depressed teen who had just lost the love of his life only to have nobody to express your feelings to. Needless to say, I was devastated for months and didn't want to interact with anyone and sort of became withdrawn. I spent less time around friends, stopped going out, and even ignored my family at certain times. I mainly just stuck to the internet for the time being until I could find myself again. I knew it would take a long time, but would eventually work. After about 3 or so months of being absolutely heartbroken, I decided that it was time to move on and find someone new. It wasn't until the summer of 2014 when I was in college where I heard about the wildly popular dating app called Tinder. It had a 4-star rating with good reviews, so I decided to give it a try. Most people used it for hookups, but I was looking for an actual relationship. I downloaded it and chose a few photos of myself that I thought looked good and searched for a local woman in my area. I am not the most attractive looking guy, so I wasn't expecting girls to be constantly right swiping me. I eventually ended up matching with a really cute girl who claimed to be just a little older than me, lived in the same city, and had similar interests. Her name was Jade, and we hit it off well. Her and I would talk on the phone almost every day and talk about our interests, and while she wasn't a 10 out of 10, she wasn't ugly. We became so close that we even talked about a few personal things that I wouldn't normally feel comfortable talking about with my friends. However, as much as I enjoyed talking to her, one thing she tried avoiding at all costs was FaceTime or Skype. Right then, I should have known that this was a red flag, but I brushed it off as anxiety and figured she wasn't comfortable yet. I know, I'm an idiot. After that, summer had ended and school had let back in, and I was finally heading into college, which meant tons of schoolwork for me. Right off the bat, Jade had started to take notice that I was becoming a bit distant from her and immediately accused me of cheating. I assured her that wasn't the case and that I was just busy with schoolwork. It seems she had understood for now, but as time progressed, her accusations of me cheating were then brought up again. No matter how many times I convinced her that I wasn't cheating, she wouldn't buy it and started to pick fights whenever she could. It was then when I started to meet the real Jade. She started asking me things that she shouldn't have known about. Private things I've only ever talked about with family or close friends. Even things that I've talked about in person with people at school who I knew she didn't know. It was at that point when I was legitimately concerned as to how she could have known all of this, and I still don't know. From there on, however, things got worse. She started messaging all of my female friends on every single social media platform I used, telling them to back off, that I was hers, and not to even try to talk to me, along with other threats. This resulted in me getting bombarded by my female friends wanting an explanation. She had even gotten my parents' phone number somehow and started telling them all of these things we would do together. I confronted her about this, but she said it was for my own good, like it had to be done. We weren't even official, and she started making it seem like we were. I had enough. I blocked her on everything and wanted nothing to do with her anymore and came to the conclusion that she was insane. Times after that suddenly felt more relaxed and I started to find myself soon after she was gone from my life. A year later, after the whole incident with Jade, I received a missed call from an unknown number and a voicemail. The voicemail said the following. Hi Max, it's Jade. I overdosed and I'm not doing so well. I miss you so much and I love you. Jade died a day later in the hospital and I felt I was to blame for it. Till this day, I still have this guilt inside of me, thinking that this was partially my fault and can't get over it. I never used online dating again after that and stuck with meeting people in person. This happened in my early 20s, around late March of 2017. I was a sophomore in college, and I was definitely no popular kid. The people who I considered as my friends were the type of people who most would refer to as the wrong people. Those who I did talk to, I spoke with very briefly about school-related stuff like upcoming assignments. I'd like to mention that I have autism, and it was often very difficult to interact with new people, which was a major factor as to why I didn't have many friends. As time progressed, I decided that I needed to find someone who I could be with, and not hang out with some edgy teens who didn't give a care in the world. I signed up for Tinder, created my account, and chose a few photos that I thought would catch attention of others. Long story short, I start swiping left on people and swiped right on a few that I would hope would right swipe me back. For the first week, it was ridiculously boring. I got no likes, no responses from my private messages, and began to think that it was all a sham. A few days go by, and to my surprise, I had finally got a match with someone. I immediately opened it and saw that I matched with a really cute girl who was just a little older than me, and while she wasn't a 10 out of 10, she wasn't ugly. We both shared similar interests together, and her personality seemed priceless. Her name was Kate, and we hit it off well. I explained about how I was on the spectrum, but thankfully she didn't seem to mind or care. We would text for hours back and forth and would even talk over the phone once in a while if we had nothing going on. One day, Kate had asked me something I really wasn't expecting to hear, especially coming from a girl. She had told me if I wanted to come by her place and watch a movie together as her parents wouldn't be home. I told her that I'd be glad to, and I was honestly extremely excited that I actually had met someone who I could interact with. When the time finally came, I got into my car and plugged in the given address into my GPS, and surprisingly enough, it wasn't too far from my house. I started the drive all the way to the house, and in about 10 minutes, my GPS led me to a big white house at the end of the street. Almost immediately, I noticed two red flags upon pulling up. All the lights had been turned off, and there were no other cars in the driveway, even though she claimed she had a car. However, I didn't come here for nothing, and I stepped out of my car and texted Kate, letting her know that I was here. Within seconds, she texts back telling me to go in through the back door and that she'll meet me there. I don't even remember thinking twice about it, but I reminded myself that this was my chance to meet someone who I could have in my life. I opened the gate that led into the backyard. The grass was knee height and there was broken glass everywhere. I made my way over to the back patio, where I saw a table with four chairs surrounding it, as well as an old shed in the back. That's when I noticed that there was something sitting in one of the chairs facing away from me. However, it was too dark to see just what this thing was. I take about 3 steps forward, and something in me told me not to go any further, and that I should just get out of here. I text Kate that I wasn't comfortable with this, and that's when I see a light from a phone screen inside the house light up, and then immediately shut off. I got no response, and I then speed walked over to my car and started it up and drove out of there, not wanting to think about whatever that was. As I was about halfway home, my car started making these constant weird screeching noises. When I got out of my car to take a look, I then saw what was wrong. All 4 tires of my car had been slashed, which meant that someone had done this while I was in the backyard. I thankfully still made it home safely, but I called police to report the incident. Turns out that that house had been vacant for 3 years, and nobody was supposed to be living there. They unfortunately never found the people who damaged my car, and I had to go get my tires replaced the next day. I still think about this incident most days when going online, and I still don't know who or what was sitting in that yard chair. Alright, so this happened to me when I was 24 years old when I was living in New York at the time. I had been working at a convention center outside of Manhattan, and we'd oftentimes have to get there at pretty early hours to help the union laborers set up for whatever is being held. Whether it was a business convention, an entertainment setup, we'd always have to get everything ready no matter what. I'd also like to point out that I was using a dating app that I believe went by the name of OkCupid ever since I had broken up with a 2-year toxic relationship with my ex-boyfriend. One day, I was at work filling out some paperwork in my office as usual when I get a notification on my phone from the app. Some guy that went by the name of Dylan had messaged me asking what I was up to. His avatar had one of those anonymous photos, so I kindly rejected him, telling him that I couldn't talk now as I was at work. Not even a minute later, I get yet another notification, and this time, he sends me a photo of something. It took me about a good second to realize that it was me working in my office. Let me point out that there were at least 100 people, if not more, in the convention area, and my office is right in front of it with a big window. I was skeptical at first and figured that it was possibly one of my coworkers playing their idea of a joke. I immediately blocked the account and temporarily disabled my OkCupid account and even closed the blinds. As soon as I got out of work, the first day of the event was over, and I received an iMessage from an unknown number. When I opened the message, I saw a photo of myself on the couch taken through a window. I felt my entire world start to die as I saw what I was looking at, and I of course blocked the number and went straight to the police. However, for whatever reason, they couldn't trace it as to where it led to or who it belonged to, which I call BS, but whatever. I haven't received any messages since then, and I never heard from Dylan again.